Hi, I'm David Petersam with Admissions Consultants. Too often, we see prospective applicants with multiple MCAT scores that really leave us wishing we could have reached out to them sooner, as in before they took the MCAT multiple times. You can get admitted to med school, let there be no doubt about that. However, it is an extremely competitive process, and it's made much more difficult by avoidable applicant mistakes, such as sitting for the MCAT multiple times. The concerns with having multiple MCAT scores are threefold. Number one, the admissions committee will see all of your scores since 2003, and unfortunately, not all those schools will take your highest or your most recent score either. Number two, there is nothing worse than going from, say, a 33 to, say, a 29 and making the admissions committee wonder which one is your real score. And number three, the admissions committee will wonder why you didn't wait until you're ready to take the test. Put yourself in the position of the admissions committee. In front of you are two solid applicants competing for the last remaining spot in your class. They are identical in every way. Their grades and majors are equally impressive, as are their extracurriculars, interview impressions, story themes, and wow factors. The only difference is that applicant A needed 3 MCAT attempts to reach a score of 30, and applicant B only needed 1 attempt to achieve that same score. So which one would you choose? It's not a trick question. In this hypothetical example, and yes, in real life there are no ceteris paribus occurrences, the admissions committees will always choose applicant B, who only needed 1 attempt to achieve his desired score. To give yourself every possible advantage in the admissions process, you have to start planning well in advance. And one of the tasks you need to do, if you truly plan to maximize your chances, is to take the MCAT just once. Make sure you come across as the type of person who lives by the motto, plan your work and work your plan. So now that we've explained what to do, let's look at some pointers on how to do it. First of all, preparation is key. The MCAT is an extremely rigorous test that generally requires hundreds of hours of studying. Give yourself adequate time to prepare and know which courses cover material you will find on the MCAT. You also have to know what to study. This may sound straightforward, but too many test takers study material unnecessarily, either because they think the material will be covered or because they are the recipients of bad MCAT advice. For instance, let's look at solution chemistry. You will need to be able to define electrolytes with examples. However, you will not be required to know the percent solubility of glucose in water. Should you self-study, hire a tutor, or take a course? We're not a test prep company, so we feel very comfortable offering impartial advice on this matter. And here's what we want you to do. Start with a diagnostic practice test. We strongly recommend the free practice test available at www.e-mcat.com. Take it under simulated conditions. This means turn off your cell phone and time yourself. How did you do? Clearly, if you ace the test, you don't need to prepare any further. You simply need to schedule a time and take the test. If you ace much of the test, and only need to focus on a few sections, then read those answer explanations for the questions that you missed. Do they make sense? If so, you can probably get away with self-studying. If, on the other hand, the answer explanations are not entirely clear, then you may benefit from a tutor, since a prep course is going to be comprehensive and largely a waste of your time. Finally, if the diagnostic reveals that you need help across the board, and the answer explanations are not entirely clear, then you may benefit from a prep course. Do you believe you may suffer from test anxiety? At Admissions Consultants, we quantify test anxiety as a difference in your test scores from being comfortable in your home under simulated conditions to the score you receive when you take the test for real. If you believe there will be an appreciable difference between these two scores, please call us at 703-242-5885, and we'll be glad to help you. Too many test takers don't believe there is anything they can do about test anxiety, and today that is no longer the case. Be fully prepared the day of your test. Make sure you know where you are going. Be sure to bring proper identification. Be sure to get a good night's sleep. Be sure to bring snacks and drinks for your 3 10-minute breaks. And while they are considered officially optional, we strongly encourage you to take them. So in conclusion, don't take the MCAT until you feel like your score is plateaued. And when is that? Quite simply, when you're not seeing the benefit from additional studying and your practice scores are no longer increasing. Alternatively, if you're one of the lucky few who starts practicing and you're already scoring very high, then by all means, schedule time to take the test and knock it out.